Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar. In this video, I am going to discuss about blue-green deployment strategy. It is also called a zero-downtime deployment process because in this deployment process, ports are not creating or replacing. Instead of new ports are creating for the new deployment along with existing deployment. Let's look at some visual diagram for the understanding. This diagram represents a blue-green deployment process. This is the application example.com. At any given point of time, only one deployment will be active. For example, blue deployment is active for my application and other deployment will be idle or passive. In this condition, green deployment is idle. Now, new version of the application is getting tested and validated in green deployment. Once you fully tested and validate software or application in the green deployment, then you will switch the traffic off all incoming. Now go to the green deployment instead of the current blue deployment. Green is now serving all requests and blue is idle. In case application doesn't work in the green deployment, then you can easily switch back to the blue deployment. Let's implement this deployment strategy in real time. This is my example.com project. In this folder structure, I have couple of the files. Let me explain these Kubernetes manifest or YAML file one by one. I do have manifest file for the namespace. I am creating a new namespace called hotel on the Kubernetes environment. Then I do have two manifest or YAML file for the ingress controller. One is ingress controller.yaml file and second is ingress controller stage.yaml file. ingress controller.yaml file is going to use for the production services. ingress controller.yaml file is going to point active deployment of the application either blue or green. hotel.example.com is production URL for my application and it is always point out to the stable service. Let me show you the services of the application. In the service folder, I do have two services, servicestable.yaml file, servicestage.yaml file. Let me open servicestable.yaml file. This is the stable service and it is currently pointing out the blue deployment. It means that ingress controller is sending all traffic of hotel.example.com to stable service and stable service sending request to blue deployment. Now look at the ingress controller stage.yaml file. This ingress controller is always pointing out passive or idle deployment and new version of the application is going to test it and validate it in this ingress controller. For the idle deployment, we are using the separate URL hotelstage.example.com. Developer and QA team will test and validate new version of the application by using this URL. This ingress controller will always pointing out stage service. Currently, this stage service is pointing to green deployment, that is idle. Now look at the deployment manifest. We have two deployment, manifest, one for blue and second for green deployment. In blue deployment manifest, we are running with 3 replica set and we are using the stable version of the application, that is 1.0. These are label selector, apps, hotel and version blue. Let's look at green one. We are running the green deployment with replica set 0 because this is the first time deployment and we have validated the application already. Hence, we are running the green deployment with 0 pod. Again, these are label selector for the green deployment, app equal to hotel and version equal to green. We are running the same stable version of the application in green deployment like blue deployment. Along with these regular files, I do have customization.yaml file on each folder. Customize is a client CLI tool to manage Kubernetes API object. It is already installed on version 1.1.4 and above. I am using this tool to deploy my entire project. Basically, I am running all the manifest in single command by using the customize tool. You can find individual customization.yaml file on each folder like deployment, and in the deployment folder we do have one customization.yaml file, and blue and green folder also have the customization.yaml file. I am not explaining in detail what is customize tool and how does it work. You can read more about this tool online. You can run these manifest file one by one for the project instead of in single command. Let's deploy our project. I have 3 cluster Kubernetes environment and I copied the demo project on the machine. I am going to deploy all the manifest or YAML file in a single command by using the customize tool. If you don't want to use this tool, you can apply these manifest or YAML file one by one by using standard kubectl apply command. Let's go ahead and implement. My project has been successfully implemented. Let's verify. Three ports are running for our blue deployment according our desired state. 2 services are running, one for stable and second for stage with the external load balancer 171 and 172. These are 2 deployment group, blue and green, and these are 2 replica set, one for blue and second for green. Now let's verify the application. Our application is loading fine on the browser and this is the version 1.0. Now suppose that application team release a new feature of the application. We will deploy the new application version in green deployment so that application or QA team will test or validate the application on green deployment, and it will not impact the current production application. Once new application version looks good in green deployment, then we will forward the traffic of the application to the green deployment. Let's implement. We need to modify the green deployment file. We need to modify the image for the newer application, that is 1.1. Also, we require to modify the replica set from 0 to 3 or according your requirement. Now Kubernetes will run 3 port of green deployment along with 3 port of blue deployment. Let's go ahead and save it. I'm using the Git for the version control system so that I can maintain or track the application deployment files. You can see here one file was modified. Now let's rerun the customization.yaml file. Customization tool detected a configuration changes in green deployment and apply it. Let's validate. You can see here 3 ports are running for blue deployment and 3 ports are running for green deployment. Guys, I forgot to execute one step in initially deployment. We need to delete the replica set for idle deployment group, in that case green deployment. Let's delete this one. The replica set has been deleted. Let's inspect the blue-green deployment once again. Now everything looks okay. Our production service is running on this IP address. Let's verify. Our production environment is up and online for the end user. Now application or QA team will test the application on green deployment. This is the URL for the green deployment, hotelstage.example.com. As you can see here, this is the new version of the application. This is the version 1.0 and this is the version 1.1. Application or QA team will test or validate this application on hotelstage.example.com, and once application looks okay on the green deployment, we will forward the traffic of this URL to the green deployment. To forward the traffic, required to modify servicestable.yaml file. Currently it is pointing out blue deployment. Let's modify to green deployment. Go ahead and save it. We require to rerun the customization.yaml file once again. Before running the customization.yaml file, let's commit the new changes in the Git. let's verify the changes for the end user perspective. Now you can see here production URL of the application is pointing to newer version of the application without any downtime. Once you validate your application and you are happy with the production changes, then you can either keep running the pod for the blue deployment or delete them. I would prefer remove them. Let's look at the process. Change the replica set from 3 to 0. Go ahead and save it. Now we require to rerun customization.yaml file. Now you can see here ports has been terminated for blue deployment. If you want, you can delete the replica set for the blue deployment now. Now let's verify the application once again. Everything looks okay. Now suppose that end users found a bug in the production application and application team wants to roll back to the version 1.0. In green blue deployment, rollback are very easy. Let's see how. Currently the production environment is pointing out green deployment. So now we require to change it from green to blue. Now we require to modify the blue deployment file. Change the replica set from 0 to 3 and save it. Similar time, change some setting in green deployment file. Change replica set from 3 to 0. Go ahead and save it. Let's rerun the customization.yaml file. Couple of the file has been changed. Let's verify the production application on browser. It should point to version 1.0. Go ahead and refresh. Yes, excellent. Now it is pointing to the last stable version of the application, that is 1.0. So that is a complete process about blue-green deployment. We can deploy new version of the application and roll back without any downtime. That's it in this video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.